guys, welcome back to my channel. I apologize about the lighting in today's video. It's a little bit darker because I'm filming later on in the day. I want to talk about something that I'm very passionate about, especially now that I'm a new mom, and that topic is breastfeeding, but more specifically how I was able to successfully transition from bottle feeding to breastfeeding. Now, whether or not you're in this current situation or you're just someone who is struggling with breastfeeding, I totally understand what you're going through. It is hard. I think a lot of people don't realize how physically, mentally, emotionally exhausting and taxing it can be on you, especially after just giving birth. You know, it's just a lot to handle. It's just giving birth to a human being is already such a huge deal. Bear with me as I kind of go through my own experience and also as I share my tips and advice on what I went through, and maybe hopefully it will help some of you guys out. So let's jump into how it all began. After I gave birth to Audrey, the nurses at the hospital were asking me whether I wanted to formula feed or breastfeed, and I told them that I wanted to breastfeed exclusively. Now, this is something that I've decided even before she was born. I just thought to myself, if I was capable of doing that, I wanted to try doing that first. So I was really set on breastfeeding. Once she was born, we did skin to skin right away. She latched on perfectly. Everything was seemingly going well until the nurses told me that Audrey was suffering from low blood sugar, and that whatever milk, if I was even producing any at the time, which I don't think I was, wasn't sufficed. She needed to have something in her system ASAP. So we resorted to having to give her formula, and throughout the time there, she was basically given formula because my milk didn't come in yet. So as I was trying to manually pump, she was just given formula the whole time. Later, we found out that Audrey had jaundice and that she had to undergo photolight therapy, which means she wasn't able to room with us, and also that took time away from her breastfeeding. But the nurses did offer to bring her in every time it was time for her feeding, but me and my husband concluded that if we were to do that, that would take time away from her treatment, and we wanted to go home as soon as possible. By that time, I think we were at the hospital for a couple of days already, so I was just so tired and just eager to go home. So we decided to, instead of bringing her back and forth, to just leave her under the lights as long as she needed to. Then by the time we went home, basically she was already used to the nipple of the bottle, and she was having a hard time breastfeeding just because getting milk from a breast and getting milk from a bottle or from a nipple is just totally different. Obviously, with the flow of the nipple on a bottle, it's a lot faster, less work needs to be done. So that's when all my problems began, because she was kind of confused between the breast and the bottle. During the time, besides being physically drained, mentally drained, emotionally drained, I think I was suffering from slight postpartum depression too. It was just a lot to take in. We were all sleep deprived. And on top of that, I felt like a failure for not being able to breastfeed my own child. So it was just really hard on me, but I never gave up trying to breastfeed. The nurses did warn me that it was gonna be hard from trying to get her to go back on the breast, but like I said in the beginning, this was something that I was really determined to do. Eventually, a couple of days afterwards, my milk came in, so I was really engorged to the point where I had to use my electric pump to kind of flush out the milk that was in there, and whatever milk that we received, I gave it to Audrey. So she was drinking it from a bottle, and at the time it wasn't that much yet, so she was doing maybe half formula, half breast milk. But then as I kept pumping, I think my milk was still trying to regulate itself. So after a couple of days, we transitioned from half formula feeding, half breast milk, to completely, like, exclusively just breast milk. So she was taking breast milk from a bottle. So just a tip for anyone, during this engorgement period, I just pumped and pumped and pumped, and that's when I started to build my milk stash. So if you plan on pumping exclusively, or if you just want to build the stash just in case, I definitely recommend to take advantage of that engorgement period. As time passed, Audrey grew bigger and so did her appetite. So the milk that she was taking in obviously increased as far as ounces goes, and at the time I was just pumping exclusively, and I felt a lot of pressure, and I felt the anxiety of seeing the numbers of how much milk I was producing, and then seeing how Audrey was just taking the milk in, and I definitely felt just the stress of trying to keep up with how much milk she was taking in. Literally, there were a lot of times too where we were doing bottle to bottle. Like after I pumped, that was what she would drink, and it would just be so tiring because I didn't have any excess. I would just give her whatever I had. She would finish up all the extra milk that I stashed away. So I was starting to worry, and I was trying to figure out what I could do to increase my milk supply again while still pumping exclusively. And I did a bunch of research, and I found all these different methods, and these are the ones that I tried. Number one was staying hydrated. I drank a lot of liquids. I drank water, I drank juice, almond milk. Gatorade, I heard, was good for increasing your milk supply. A tip, if you're someone who's struggling with trying to stay hydrated while breastfeeding, what I would tell myself is after every feed, I'd have to drink like a bunch of water. So just basically drink after I feed, drink. After I feed, drink again. Second tip is making sure that you're eating well and you're eating regularly. I know that after you give birth, it's sometimes really difficult to remember to feed yourself because you're just so worried about other things, whether it's the baby, trying to worry about getting the house together. Just believe me, I know how that feels, that it's so easy to just completely neglect yourself, but try not to. I made sure that not only did I eat regularly, but I ate nutritious food. So I increased my protein intake, I ate carbs, just things that will fill me up, veggies, fruits. Third is, I read somewhere that oatmeal can help also with increasing milk supply. So I started having oatmeal every day for breakfast, just with some fruit on the side. So I ate a lot of oatmeal as well. But above all, I think the most important thing that helped me was to pump frequently. So I put myself on a pumping schedule. I think I had an alarm set for every hour. I would pump for 15 minutes, just straight power pumping, just to stimulate and get things going. So that would help increase my supply. So I did that for a while, and that was really tiring because if I wasn't trying to feed her directly, I was power pumping or pumping for her next meal or trying to take care of other things. It was hard, but try putting yourself on just a strict pumping schedule, and that might help you. You can tell it was a really rough time for me, and then on top of that, I even got mastitis, which was hard to deal with because I had a fever, I was really sore, I had chills. It's basically like having the flu. Eventually, I came to a point where I had to ask myself what I wanted to do. Did I want to commit to this pumping lifestyle, if you will, and continue to pump for a year, which was my goal, to breastfeed her for at least a year? Or should I just give up and just give her formula instead, which seemed like at the time the most easiest thing to do. But in the end, I had to ask myself what was best for me and what was best for her. And knowing that I was going to be a stay-at-home mom, I wanted to really try to breastfeed. So because breastfeeding her directly made the most sense, I started to do even more research on how I could transition from bottle feeding her to breastfeeding. And I read somewhere that a baby is more efficient at getting the milk out than a pump is. Something I also came across while doing my research is that breastfeeding is a concept of supply and demand. Whether you're directly breastfeeding or pumping, if the body notices that milk is being emptied out regularly, then it'll produce more. Your body basically knows best on how much milk your baby needs. So the first thing I did was call a lactation consultant. I felt that if I saw a professional, I'd be more comfortable and more motivated to go through with this. And so the lactation consultant helped me position her the right way. She taught me how to latch her on properly. She also gave me advice and tips on how to treat my mastitis. So she told me to use a combination of hot and cold to help with the swelling. She also gave me a nipple shield to help with the soreness, and also advised me to start using a nipple balm because all the soreness and just the pain in general was also preventing me from breastfeeding properly. The second thing I started doing was using a breastfeeding pillow. For me, this helped me a lot because it just made everything more comfortable as far as trying to position her while breastfeeding. The third thing I did was try to offer her the breast even before she was hungry or even before she was crying out in hunger. I noticed that if I tried to breastfeed her while she was already upset, it was a lot harder to try to do than when she was more calm and quiet. I find that when she was like that, she was a little bit more receptive to it. I also tried to pump to express some milk before I tried to feed her, just so she can kind of sense or taste some of the milk, so she would know that milk was coming out of it and that would motivate her. Also, try your best to stay patient and not stress out. I know that's a lot easier said than done, believe me. But for me, I noticed the more I stressed out about it, the more I felt tense. The more it took away from me trying to spend time with her or trying to bond with her. Looking back at it, I realized I was so stressed and so caught up with this whole breastfeeding thing that I really wish that I treasured more of my time with her when she was so young, because now when I look back, the main thing that I think about is trying to breastfeed her instead of remembering how small she was. Moving on, we started feeding her a little bit at a time, just constantly trying to offer the breast, and then we did have some successes. So slowly she would start getting used to being on the breast, and then little by little, she would start drinking from the breast or eating from the breast. And then so at the time we were kind of paranoid whether she was getting enough, so we were still giving her a bottle of breast milk maybe after a feeding or two, just in case, because we weren't sure if she was hungry or if she got enough. But then after a visit to the pediatrician, we found out that she was gaining weight and she was healthy. So then eventually we stopped giving her a bottle, and basically we're reaching to the point where we are right now, which is she's exclusively being breastfed. It's funny because my husband even purchased slow flow bottles, or the Komotomo bottles, because, you know, just for convenience sake, just whenever we wanted to give her a bottle. But I was just so scarred and so traumatized by this whole experience that to this day we haven't even used any of those bottles. She's been directly breastfeeding this whole time, and I really want to try to reach my goal of at least a year. To this day, my breastfeeding journey is not over. I know that there's always gonna be something, but for the most part, breastfeeding has been going beautifully, and I'm so grateful. Fed is best, whether it's breastfeeding or bottle feeding. Your baby is going to get the best from you no matter what. That pretty much concludes my story, and I hope you guys found it helpful or informative. I wish you all the best of luck, anyone who's breastfeeding or who is trying to breastfeed, because it's not easy, but it's definitely worth it. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe and like the video down below, and I'll see you guys next time.